I'm gonna let you go home with something warm in your soul.
Give it to me.
Don't stop now.
And I want you to take it and you tuck it wherever you want to tuck it, but I want you to carry it with you everywhere you go. Yes. Poem is called Self-Love, and poem said, do you want to see a miracle? I mean, like, do you want to see a miracle?
Yes. Yes.
Go look in the mirror.
Hello, I'm John Siegenthaler. Once again, welcome to A Word on Words. Our guest is Bell Hooks. Welcome, Bell Hooks, to A Word on Words. This book is called All About Love, New Visions.
It offends a lot of people that this intellectual is quoting M. Scott Peck, but I felt that his books, I love mass literature. I love the fact that we can have books like The Road Less Traveled, like Thomas More's Care of the Soul, that reach out with broad intellectual concepts to a wide audience. And I particularly take his definition of love as the will to nurture one's own and another's spiritual growth and link it to Eric Fromm saying, love is a combination of care, knowledge, responsibility, commitment, and trust.
But knowing that, the courage to think critically and the courage to love. I think we need to talk publicly about the courage to love. That's what I love about the best of the black freedom movement. But James Baldwin talked about love explicitly as the most difficult, dangerous, but also the most significant force in the world. Why? Because if you come from a people who have been so hated, love can become subversive and transformative, beginning by loving yourself. But he's talking about loving themselves. Why is that important? Because it's a form of agency. It gives people a sense of confidence. Agency makes a difference for people who are cutting against the grain in their perceptions.
That's the evil that I have. You have to inherit everything yourself, make the joy and the fun and the happiest time, right? That's okay. So it's like, yeah, it's short. No more away you would.
Aimé Césaire, vous êtes à la fois député de la Martinique et écrivain. Vous êtes même l'un des écrivains qui compte le plus dans les Antilles.
Au Congrès de Rome, j'ai eu l'occasion de prononcer cette phrase, mais qui exprime bien mon point de vue à ce sujet. Je disais que pour nous, écrivains noirs, il ne s'agit pas d'être comme le veulent certains des ingénieurs d'âme, mais être vraiment des créateurs d'âme. Et je crois que pour nous, aux Antilles, c'est particulièrement vrai, parce que, précisément à cause de la politique d'assimilation, il est clair que la personnalité antillaise a été étouffée et finalement, s'ignore elle-même. Il faut la révéler.
Merci, Aimé Césaire.
You know, but sometimes you ask yourself, where's the peace? Everybody always talking about peace, but as long as you find peace in what you're doing, then you're successful. And that's what people don't realize. So you got to do stuff to where you can go to sleep at night. Because the glory is in you.
Thank you.
And in that sense, everybody is committed to the act of thinking and of thought and of reflection. And there is no way that we can, as it were, close the circle so that we can simply be the conditions which have framed us. We have to reflect on what are the conditions of existence which we have not brought into existence, which have shaped us, which are always already there before we were born, with through which we become subjects. It's only through that process of reflecting and representing the world to ourselves as we live it that we become subjects.
Welcome to Caribbean Writers and Their Art, a series of conversations with some writers from the English-speaking Caribbean, in which we hope that we'll give you some sense of the exciting work that's coming out, has come out of the region, and some of the new developments that are taking place in English-speaking Caribbean literature. My name is Edward Baugh, and I'm from the University of the West Indies in Mona, Jamaica, and I'm a professor of English there. And we thought that for the opening program in this series, we could do no better than start with, as our first guest, Edward Kamau Brathwaite, who is one of the most distinguished, one of the most considerable poets of the Caribbean.
And the poem that I wrote went like this. And in it, you will see how I developed not only a sense of the geography of the Caribbean, simple as it may be, but also a sense of the history at the same time. The poem is called Calypso, quite rightly, and it begins like this. The stone had skidded, arced and bloomed into islands, Cuba, San Domingo, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, Grenada, Guadalupe, Bonaire. Curved stone hissed into reef, wave teeth fanged into clay, white splash flashed into spray, Bathsheba, Montego Bay, bloom of the arcing summers. And that is the trigger which opens my poetry.
And that's a...
Let's spell it. First letter.
L-O-G-E.
What's that?
Love.
What?
Love.
Lord, if we was possible.
Thank you, Tommy. Hello, West Indies. This is Una Marston calling you from London.